I called him up the next morning and I said, you can't say no to me because people need this. And I have to give back. And I want to start with you. Because it's crazy for you not to do these seminars. You're sending out all this stuff. Let me tell you how we're gonna do it. And I was so confident, I was so believed in it, what it was about to help. So I go, well, this is what I want to do. I want to come and I want to do the seminar. And I said, you've got the mailer that goes out all the time. Put a perk in there, right? Get them to come to the show. So you put my seminar information in the mailer that goes out. You're doing the mailer anyway. Put it in there. Okay, maybe we could do that, right? Okay, and what I'd also like you, you know, you have that newspaper that goes out every day of the show. People come in, thousands of people, they get a newspaper for that day. And I said, I want to be on the front cover of that newspaper. I want a picture of myself, and I want the story about the business of what I did, buying a losing business and turning it around. Because I know, smart enough with marketing, knowing that the photo is going to be a photo with a caption underneath it and a story. People like to read stories. But I specifically said front cover. Now, next to the registration desk, I'd like a life-size poster of me. Now that, and I go, and I was joking, I said, it's not really that tall, right? That's not really asking that much, okay? And I don't want you to put my seminar on the first day, I want you to put it on the second or the third day of the show. And so he goes, okay. And you don't have to pay me. But what I want in return is that publicity, and then I'm gonna write a contract of our verbal agreement that says, when I pack the room, standing room only, no freaking idea how I was gonna do that. Wow. And when I prove that you need seminars and there's interest, that you will not only book me again, you will pay me again, you will refer me to three other retail, because there's all these different retail shows, that they will hire me. You will personally refer me and you'll write a fabulous testimonial letter.
And
I was so confident by the next morning. Oh my gosh, I couldn't believe it. Like saying that.
Talk about taking risk.
Well, I figured I had nothing to lose. Put it all out there, right?
Yeah.
What year was that, roughly?
Oh, see, that was 20 years ago.
Yeah, I'm just thinking
about
how you're forward thinking about it.
95, maybe?
Yeah,
Yeah, so I knew enough about marketing and everything. So let me tell you that this is how it came down too. Now you can't give up. You got to work it. I got to promise, right? So now you got to be like a little marketing. I got to get shameless. And this is before I wrote the Shameless book. So I got flyers and I went to all my sales reps and I said, you all need to be there in that room. I know it's Vegas. I know you guys want to go out and party. You need to be supporting me. I want you to hand out these flyers to all of your people that are coming because I want, you know, what I said, you know why I buy from you? Because you guys help me. You help me. Every time I come and I buy from you, you give me some success tips. And sometimes your line doesn't perform as much as others, but you support my success every single time. So you've got to support them. So I had a little speech for all my sales reps. I dropped off all the flyers, and I would get on the shuttle bus in the morning. It was ridiculous. Oh, my God. I'm going up down the aisle. What are you doing this morning? You're going to come to my seminar. Here's a flyer, you know. And so I'm getting on those shuttle bus. I go back to the hotel, get on another shuttle bus. I got people doing this, you know. Pack the room, standing room only.
Wow.
And I was so bad of a speaker. I was so bad.
How bad were you?
But I was smart. I was smart. And you know what you said yesterday? I go, okay, because I was all nervous. This is how long ago it was. I had an overhead projector. Like my little fancy little overhead projector slides, and I'm testing it, making sure the light goes on. We're talking about technology, right? I'll make sure it worked right and everything. Well, you turn the frickin' light on, right? And then it didn't work because somebody walked behind and the cord wasn't working. So I have one of my sales reps like crawling around the room trying to hook the cord up. Oh my gosh. And then I just laughed. I said, ignore the man on the floor. And then I went, okay, just go with this, Deb. Just have fun with this. This is not about you. Remember, you're here for them today, and it switched. And I just went into telling success stories and giving tips and giving stuff, and that's how I launched my career.
Wow.